Well, I think you have to put them into context. This is obviously information that in some degree they've had, or the police in Portugal had right early on, and it's as a result of the review and the new investigation the Metropolitan Police have done that they've decided to get the two separate witnesses to separately produce these EFID images.
I don't know if we can look at them again, but that they are meant to be the same man, aren't they? But they are quite... they are quite similar. I mean, I don't know, would you say they're similar or not? I mean, and how helpful will they be 6 years on?
You have to remember with EFITs, these aren't photographs. Mm. You know, people haven't produced an image which is absolutely 100% a photograph of the person. What they've done is they've compiled a collection of features which they think are very similar to the person that they saw. Now, there are some similarities in things like the hairline, the lips and
the colouring,
this sort of thing, which gives people an indication of the person they're looking for. If you look at the description alone, 20 to 40 medium build dark hair, it's going to take you nowhere.
And with your experience when you worked for the Met, I mean, how crucial can EFITs be? Do you think someone might watch this or see this image and go, oh, well, I was there too, I remember that man, or the night before or the night after?
What it helps is focus people's ideas and their memories. This was a huge event, as we've seen in Praia da Luz, and anyone who was on holiday there, visiting there or lived there would not have failed to have known what was going on. So seeing that EFIT and knowing that it's not someone with a big nose or a scar or, you know, spiky hair or bald does focus on the sort of person that they are looking to interview.